Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Amen. All the earth shall bow down before you, O God, and shall sing to you, shall sing to your name, O Most High. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
All the earth shall bow down before you, O God, and shall sing to your name, O Most High. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome you to Mass this evening, the second Sunday in ordinary time. For those who don't know me, I'm Father Simon, parish priest of Bexhill. Almost didn't get here because of the closed roads, accidents and blue lights, and massive detour around via Hollington. But deep breath, I'm here. And I'm not sure, I'm afraid, what the Mass intention is tonight, but no, whatever it is, I'll hold it in my heart and offer it as it's advertised in your newsletter. I'm also going to welcome people from Bexhill who are actually joining our Mass live over the internet via my phone, which is very discreetly by the crib. I always offer them an online Mass on Saturday and Sunday, and as I'm here, well, the phone comes with me. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray.
Almighty and living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. About Zion, I will not be silent. About Jerusalem, I will not grow weary, until her integrity shines out like the dawn and her salvation flames like a torch. The nations then will see your integrity, all the kings your glory, and you will be called by a new name, one which the mouth of the Lord will confer. You are to be a crown of splendour in the hand of the Lord, a princely diadem in the hand of your God. No longer are you to be named forsaken, nor your land abandoned, but you shall be called my delight, and your land the wedded, for the Lord takes delight in you, and your land will have its wedding. Like a young man marrying a virgin, so will the one who bought you wed you. And as the bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so will your God rejoice in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all the peoples.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all the peoples.
O sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. O sing to the Lord. Bless his name.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all peoples.
Proclaim his help day by day. Tell among the nations his glory and his wonders among all the peoples.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all the peoples.
Give the Lord, you families of peoples. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all the peoples.
Worship the Lord in his temple. O earth, tremble before him. Proclaim to the nations, God is king. He will judge the peoples in fairness.
Proclaim the wonders of the Lord among all the peoples.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. There is a variety of gifts, but always the same Spirit. There are all sorts of service to be done, but always to the same Lord, working in all sorts of different ways in different people. It is the same God who is working in all of them. The particular way in which the Spirit is given to each person is for a good purpose. One may have the gift of preaching with wisdom given him by the Spirit. Another may have the gift of preaching instruction given him by the same Spirit, and another the gift of faith given by the same Spirit. Another again, the gift of healing through this one Spirit. One, the power of miracles, another prophecy, another the gift of recognizing spirits, another the gift of tongues, and another the ability to interpret them. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, who distributes different gifts to different people, just as he chooses. This is the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. wedding at Cana in Galilee. The mother of Jesus was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited. When they ran out of wine, since the wine provided for the wedding was all finished, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus said, "Woman, why turn to me? My hour has not come yet." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." There were 6 stone water jars standing there, meant for the ablutions that are customary among the Jews. Each could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water," and they filled them to the brim. "Draw some out now," he told them, "and take it to the steward." They did this, the steward tasted the water, and it had turned into wine. Having no idea where it came from, only the servants who had drawn the water knew, the steward called the bridegroom and said, "People generally serve the best wine first and keep the cheaper sort till the guests have had plenty to drink. But you have kept the best wine till now." This was the first of the signs given by Jesus. It was given at Cana in Galilee. He let his glory be seen, and his disciples believed in him.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
St. Paul writes about the diversity of gifts, and today's readings certainly are a gift to the preacher. Should I resist the temptation to use them to comment on the happenings in Downing Street? Perhaps I shouldn't, but perhaps I will. Certainly, our Lord and his disciples knew that they had been invited to a party, for it would have been an event of the whole village, and there was lots of wine, especially after Jesus got involved. A bring your own booze event, perhaps. It's about 900 bottles of wine that he creates, by the way. That should have gotten through the week. But seriously, there is a really important point, isn't there? Because we know that there were many weddings, many funerals during the pandemic that could not be celebrations and commemorations of the whole community. The expression of our great faith, the means of our communion together around the altar of the Lord, is most clearly seen when the community is gathered. And Isaiah spoke of this new version of the city of Jerusalem, a place where no one should feel alone or unprotected. The covenant ushered in is relational. A people once alienated from God are assured of the joyful union of heaven and earth. And this covenant is expressed in the body of Christ, the church. And so it is a wound when the community is prevented from gathering due to secular restrictions, even if we understand the reason why. In this celebration of the Eucharist, we're offering our bread and wine, the bread and expression of all our labours of the past week, the wine and expression of our joy. And yet something is still lacking, and this is alluded to in the wedding of Cana. The 6 stone jars, as we know, each hold 20 to 30 gallons. And as we know, numbers for God's people are symbolic. And 6, as we might think of the 6 days of creation followed by a day of rest, shows that even in that great abundance, there is something more to come. And it is impressive that Jesus creates what this is about 150 gallons, these 900 bottles in our terms, and yet we see that promise fulfilled tonight in the celebration of Mass, the Eucharist, the memorial of his death and resurrection, and we have that divine sustenance, his body, blood, soul, and divinity in Holy Communion.
also note at the wedding in Cana that the first guest mentioned is the Mother of God, Mary. And understanding, of course, Christ's pre-existence as part of the Trinity, Our Lady is the first person in the mind of God, because she is going to be the channel of the Incarnation. She has a real role in our redemption. And she remains a perfect mediator for us. Jesus loves his mother and takes note of her requests. And he's not being rude to her in saying woman. Woman was a very noble title, meaning Our Lady. And he's not being rude in saying what to me and to you about this event. He's simply indicating that this is not meant to be his time. But even so, he agrees to work this first miracle for his mother. And she has great regard for the guests. So Our Lady has regard for God's people, and Jesus responds to her request. So let's continue to petition Our Lady. This passage from the wedding of Cana, as you would imagine, is often chosen for weddings because it shows us as Catholics that we want Jesus in our marriage. Something lacking if that wedding takes place outside of the proper form. And our Lord's present at Cana, he elevates the natural marriage that was instituted by God at creation to it now being the dignity of a sacrament. And those of us who are afforded the dignity of the sacraments will take heed of St. Paul's lesson on the diversity of gifts. The sacraments of initiation and reconciliation, when we need it, fills us up to the brim with God's grace. And that should then overflow and be used in the sacraments of service of communion, that's holy orders and marriage, all for the building up of the kingdom of God. Those people who enjoy some privilege in their life should expect to find greater scrutiny of their actions. But we should be careful, because all of us know, there but for the grace of God go I, and we need to protect ourselves from that, shall we say, arrogance that perhaps we have seen in recent weeks, and we don't want to fall into that same trap. I'm sure you can probably all think of a time when we probably didn't follow the guidance as well as we should have done, and may have put somebody at risk. Our unity as the people of God, it's a gift from him. It's the Holy Spirit dwelling inside of us who brings about that wonderful communion of the faithful. And that communion of the faithful we must consent to, because of course we need to be in communion before we receive Holy Communion. And of course we know from St. James the Apostle that faith without charity is dead. So let's all of us discern how we're being called to serve God, serve his holy people in the Holy Catholic Church. So let's make our communion together as we profess the creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess from baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through to the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through to the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvellous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and
Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Peter, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings of a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gift of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light and peace. To us also, your servants who, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter out of my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. You have prepared a table before me, and how precious is the chalice that quenches my thirst.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I believe somebody's giving an appeal for Spock this evening. Who's doing that? Okay, no one. Well, we all know the Society for the Protection of the Unborn Child. We know that abortion is always an intrinsic evil. We know that even in our country, with its so-called safe and legal means, it's completely out of control. But if we are going to influence anything in this country, we need to be able to provide people with real choice, not pro-choice, but real choice to be pro-life. And so today's collection is for Spark the Society for the Protection of Unborn Children. So please do give generously to that. Father Paul's away, as you know, he's away next weekend as well, so we'll be covering again. But next Saturday evening, we'll get my assistant, Father Rajesh, and he's up normally in Battle tomorrow, and I'm here tonight. And then next weekend, we're going to swap over. So he'll come next week in the evening, and I'll go up the road and come back for the morning masses. And somehow we fit in our masses as well in Bexhill. But thank God Father Paul gets a break, because I know he's been a great ministry to you in these trying times. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
not Father's own.